The Nerdgasm Talk Podcast is brought to you by Spaces Philly. If you love podcasts, go to spacesphilly.com where you can check out Lulu and Pop, Both Sides, Turntables, Jump Thoughts, Super Tongue, and the Nerd Coalition's very own No Gimmicks Needed. Visit spacesphilly.com today, and now, feel the Nerdgasm.
Which brings me to your boy Ezra Miller, The Flash.
Why gotta be my boy?
Because you have been going the longest. So, now somebody who has been shown to have this behavior has still been here. And that's Ezra Miller. So he's back in news again, and he got arrested. And Ezra Miller got arrested apparently because he was at a bar. Somebody was singing karaoke, and it's a song that he did not like, and he went up and grabbed the microphone from the girl or the guy, I think it was the girl, forcefully, and somebody who was there, I guess he was playing pool or playing darts, something like that, was confronting him, and he tried to charge this guy, and people at the bar were trying to calm him down. He got arrested. And then this couple who he was staying with, who bailed him out of jail, he sneaks into their room, and he takes like their wallet and their passwords and stuff, and threatens to kill them.
What in the? I didn't hear about that.
Ezra Miller has been.
I know he was threatening the KKK like not too long ago, but other than that, I was like, oh, okay.
You said he was threatening the KKK.
Yeah, he just made a video like, yo, KKK, I'm gonna come after you. I was like, okay. I'm not threatened. it was just weird. And now hearing this is like, there's definitely some substance that has to be involved.
Yeah, but you know what? Warner Brothers played the game that they love. They call it the shh game. They don't want nobody to know about this game. Because remember that whole thing? It was just like Ezra Miller was calling Vito, choking that lady.
Yep.
And it was just like, oh, we just pushed it under the rug. He was like, what the hell, man? Was she lying? Was this? Everybody thought that when something happens and they're a celebrity says, they always think it's just a prank all the time. Because I remember when the Will Smith thing first happened, my wife was talking about something. It looked like a prank. I'm like, people, y'all don't understand what the shit y'all saying. We live in 2022. This is not the way to prank. This is not the early 2000s. It's not the late 90s where, you know, you can be, you know, punked like with Ashton Kutcher and do some crazy outlandish things and then nobody think of it, anything like that. If you just go and you slap somebody, if you're on a video and you kick a dog without context, you got some problems.
Yeah.
So why in the hell would I be on video choking somebody, or why would I go slap somebody in front of millions of people at an award ceremony because for it to be fake? And then you got this, I don't know. That makes no sense in this time period.
I think it's more of like, there's no way that can happen. It's like almost like again, when I first saw it, I was almost in disbelief. I was like, that didn't happen.
Uh-huh.
Well, so I take it as a coping type of thing. Like a coping mechanism.
Well, here's the article. The article is read because I am actually picking up this article from the John Campy show, who had pulled the article up on his show. It says the unnamed couple from Hilo, Hawaii, I hope I'm saying that right, recently filed a restraining order against the Flash star Ezra Miller after the actor allegedly threatened them and stole from them. The couple has issued a petition for a temporary restraining order claiming that the actor who was staying with them threatened to kill them and stole from them. According to the court document, Miller allegedly burst into the couple's bedroom and is quoted as saying, "I will bury you with your slut wife." The order also states Ezra Miller is famous and wealthy. This makes access to weapons much easier, as well as sending associates to harass the couple, in parentheses, along with a wallet the actor reportedly took, social security card, passport, driver's license, and bank cards. At the time of the writing at this article, these items have not yet been returned to the couple.
Well, something's going on. I don't know what it is, but I know when you said Warner Brothers is quiet, I think they're doing the same thing that Disney did with Roseanne. Yeah, they're just waiting. They're just waiting.
But here's the thing, though. I strongly believe that Warner Brothers was like, oh, shit, well, the Will Smith thing happened. And they felt that was a bigger story. And they could just keep the Ezra Miller thing at the bottom. And then what happened is the Will Smith thing is starting to run its course.
Yeah.
But this shit is serious because, first of all, once again, Ezra Miller has a history of this kind of behavior.
Right.
Okay, whereas Will Smith does not. So now with this kind of behavior, Warner Bros. Also has a history of throwing this shit under the rug and not taking it seriously.
Right.
Which is something that I'm like, okay, I'm not a fan of that, and I think y'all really need to get up on the ball. Now, here's the thing. The people are saying, well, are they going to replace Flash or reboot Flash? Here's the thing. The movie's done. The movie's done. Warner Brothers is not going to redo that whole movie.
Too much money.
It's too much money. It's like it's delayed because they want to change something. Here's the reason why. It's delayed because the suits got involved and they was putting out these movies to like, oh, look at the slate we got, and realize that if y'all trying to do a DCEU, y'all putting the movies out in the wrong order.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, what if y'all put out Ant-Man, the first Ant-Man, before y'all put out Age of Ultron, y'all lost. Because they're talking about the events that happened already in a movie that we haven't even seen yet.
Right.
Can you imagine if Spider-Man Far From Home came out before Infinity War, just because it could be the sequel the next year to Spider-Man Homecoming?
We all be confused.
And we're like, what blip are you talking about?
We all be confused.
So that's what's happening, because Shazam 2 was 2023. They pushed that up to this year. Mm-hmm. Because there's some events that's happening in Shazam that go along with Black Adam. Really? Really? Because I don't know, aren't they in the same kind of realm, universe, lore? So then they had to push Flash and Aquaman back because certain things haven't happened yet. Wow. Okay, and they want to fix some things. It's a whole mess over there. And now, but the movie's done. They can't, they're not going to, and they won't do that and then replace a whole another actor to play Ezra Miller. He's in there. Mm-hmm. And now he's probably going to be playing a big part. The question is, what do they do for Ezra Miller going in the future?
Right.
Because there has to be some action taken to Ezra Miller. You can't. Y'all talking about slamming somebody? You really can't do this.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, honestly, you know, he got arrested, but he got bailed out. But threatening to kill somebody is a serious offense, and stealing and the stuff is still not been returned to these people yet. As of the writing of this article,
right?
The man has some serious problems. There have been talks about how he has outbursts on set sometimes, and he could be a little bit hard to work with type of side. I'm not really familiar with those reports because I haven't looked up into those reports.
Right. But
there have been the murmurs of that being happening with Ezra Miller, and especially when it comes to stuff like the Fantastic Beasts movie and so that, all that stuff. Like, he's in all these joints. But the thing is, I don't know how Warner Bros. Right now is being forced to handle this shit, and they can't. The Flash is going to make a lot of money, despite how you feel about DC or not.
Right.
You know, it's going to make a lot of money, but that's still no excuse to push it under the rug while we got to have Will Smith be banned for the Oscars for 10 years.
Right.
So, I know I've been talking a minute, so your takes on that.
No, I pretty much what you said. It, I think there's some type of substance he's on at this current moment, and I hope he gets better. If it comes to Warner Brothers firing Ezra Miller, it's like, who they got left? Jason Momoa. And it's like they've already been losing this game, and now it's just like, because they lost Henry Cavill, they lost Ben Affleck. Gal Gadot is still in it, but I mean, you know, her acting isn't the best.
Yeah.
Jason Momoa is probably the biggest star you really have at the moment. Mm-hmm. And now you got someone that's completely messing up everything you guys are trying to work on.
Yeah.
Or a universe that you guys just, at this point, you just gotta chalk it up. So, damn. I don't know what Ezra Miller's doing. I hope Warner Brothers figure it out soon. Because I think he only getting jobs from Warner Brothers, as far as I know.
You know what? You might
Because Harry Potter, DC, I don't see him in anything else.